when Musa, who is the prophet most told of in the Quran, because he represents this eternal struggle between the pharaonic model and the Mosaic model, the model of liberation and the model of control, and the struggle still goes on. When he was told to go to Pharaon, he said, "Idhab anta wa akhuka bi'ayati." Go, you and your brother, with my son. Idhaba ila Fir'auna innahu tagha. Go to Fir'aun because he has transgressed the boundaries. And one of the beauties of the Quran, it never goes into details. It always leaves this kind of veiling, because the details become very, disgusting of what people do, the details of their crimes. We don't want to know the details. إِنَّهُ طَغَى فَقُولَا لَهُ قَوْلًا لَيِّنًا. And speak to him gently. Speak to him gently. لَعَلَّهُ يَتَذَكَّرُ أَوْ يَخْشَى. That perhaps he might recollect and have awe of his Creator. This is Moses, the prophet, speaking to Pharaoh, the worst tyrant in the world at his time, and one of the worst in the history of human civilization. A man who said, "Ana rabbukum al-a'la," a man who claimed to be God, and yet the Quran says, "Speak to this man who's claiming to be me gently." قُلَ لَهُ قَوْلًا لَيِّنًا. Why? لَعَلَّهُ يَتَذَكَّرُ وَيَخْشَى. قَالَ رَبَّنَا إِنَّنَا نَخَافُ أَن يَفْرُطَ عَلَيْنَا. We have fear that he will do terrible things to us. Or he will oppress us. So this is the human fear of opposing power. There is that fear. قَالَ لَا تَخَافَ. Have no fear. Have no fear. إِنَّنِي مَعْكُمَا أَسْمَعُ وَأَرَى. I am with you. I hear and I see. فَأْتِيَاهُمْ فَقُولَا إِنَّا رَسُولَ رَبِّكَ فَأَرْسَلْ مَعْنَا بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ. Go to him and say, "Give us the children of Israel, وَلَا تُعَذِّبْهُمْ," and don't persecute them. This is Jihad al-Akbar. The Quran didn't say, create a little cell and go and blow up the pyramids, and after you do that, assassinate the head of state, and do this all furtively and secretly, and don't tell anybody. It said, go and declare your truth. Go and speak your truth. Why? Because don't despair of the mercy of your Lord, even in your enemies. Because Iblis is the one, Ablasa. He's the one that despairs. Never despair. The Prophet ﷺ said, أَحْبِبْ حَبِيبَكَ هُونَ مَا عَسَنِكُمْ بَغِيبَكَ يَوْنَ مَا وَأَحْبِبْ بَغِيبَكَ هُونَ مَا عَسَنِكُمْ حَبِيبَكَ يَوْنَ مَا. Never hate to an extreme. Never loathe anybody to an extreme, because he may one day be a close friend, an intimate friend. I mean, we should beware of hating those who do us wrong. We should be very wary of this. And I'm not saying not to feel righteous indignation, because that is a gift from God. But righteous indignation is not anger and hatred. It's something that emerges in the soul when you see wrong, and it causes you to right that wrong in the appropriate way. And that is the message of Islam. Righting wrongs in the appropriate way. It's not blowing up indiscriminately. It's not killing people that you don't know whether they're for you or against you. It's acting civilly. It's acting according to the law. And when we fight with the rules of engagement. We're not utilitarians. We're not people that believe that the end justifies the means. We're people that believe if the end is noble, then the means must be noble to achieve that end. Salaam alaikum.